even if he was the one that did it, it would have been harder to do, but it would have been the same scenario. Like I said earlier, we have to examine our hearts, and I've learned how to do that personally in my walk relationship with God and the Lord Jesus Christ. And when you do that, you get a peace. There's a peace that I can't even describe. So when I tell you this is hard, it is very difficult. But in addition to that, I have great peace. And it allows me to forgive. I've already forgiven, and this forgiveness is not for anybody else, but God and me. And we're supposed to love our neighbors. And if we do that, that will X out all of this madness. We don't have to worry about killings or racial discrimination or any other type of violence and mistreating each other. We are humans. And my prayer, even before this, I was one to pray. Myself and the fellow intercessors at my church, we pray for our local police departments, Skokie Police Department, abroad. That's just a regular thing that we do. So how can I then live in my life the way I live it now in this situation change that? That would make me a complete hypocrite. Almost definitely. I would have been a little harder, and I probably would have cried a lot more. But yeah, most definitely. And I've already prayed for him. I've already prayed for his family. I don't hate anybody. I am livid about what happened. I don't understand it. I'm broken, so heartbroken. But that doesn't mean that I can't have compassion and forgive. I'm not perfect. No, I've never done anything lawless on that side, but I've made some bad decisions in life, and God forgave me for my mistakes. So